In this video, we're going to finish out the CUDA software free worksheet under the geometry section, side, 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 and side, angle, side, congruence, otherwise known as SSS and SAS. So picking up where we left off with number 11, our directions say to state what additional information is required in order to know that the triangles are congruent for the reason given. So number 11, it wants us to use side, angle, side. So we know that side HI is congruent to side GI. We also know that angle JIH is congruent to angle EIG because they are vertical angles and vertical angles are congruent. So we have a side angle, and in this triangle we have a side and an angle. And for side angle side, remember that angle has to be the included angle, so between the two sides. Therefore, IJ, this other side, needs to be congruent to IE. So segment IJ needs to be congruent to segment IE in order for side angle side congruence. Because again, we have side angle side, side angle side. Let's move on to number 12. Number 12 states that these angles are congruent for SAS. So in order for that to be true, note that we have our two sides, LK. A side is congruent to HI, a side, LM, a side is congruent to HG, a side, but we need those included angles to also be congruent. We need angle L, which is the included angle for sides LM and LK, to be congruent to angle H, which is the included for GH and IH. Therefore, we need angle L to be congruent to angle H. And that will give us side, angle, side congruence. In number 13, we want triangle DZX to be congruent to triangle YXZ with side, side, side congruence. Now note, since they share a similar segment, ZX, we know that ZX is congruent to itself. So now we have two corresponding sides are congruent. We just need to make the third corresponding side congruent. And that's going to be that YZ is congruent to DX. So in order for side, side, side congruence, YZ needs to be congruent to DX. And number 14, again, it asks for side, side, side congruence. We have that RS is congruent to XY. We have that ST is congruent to YZ. So in order for side, side, side congruence, we need the third sides to also be congruent. So we need TR congruent to ZX, and that will make these two triangles congruent. So TR, the segment, needs to be congruent to ZX. And number 15, we're going back to side angle side, SAS. We have that VU is congruent to YX, and since angle U and angle X are both indicated to be right angles, they are both congruent because they're both equal in measure, but for side angle side, we need a last side to be congruent. And remember that angle is the included angle, which is indeed the 90 degrees. So side WU has to be congruent to side ZX. That way we get side angle side and side angle side congruence. In number 16, we're moving back to side, side, side congruence. That means that the three sides of one triangle have to be congruent to the three corresponding sides of another triangle. So since GF is congruent to WX and XY is congruent to FE, we need our last sides to be congruent. So that would be GE congruent to WY. So segment GE is congruent to segment WY, if we have side, side, side congruence. For side, angle, side, these two triangles share a common side, and that segment GF is congruent to itself. So now we just need the included angle to be congruent, which is angle F in both triangles. So for this first triangle, it will be angle EFG, and for the second triangle, it will be angle QFG. So angle EFG has to be congruent to angle QFG for side angle side congruence. Since we have two sides that are congruent, the included angle must also be congruent. And lastly in this video, side angle side. Note that we have that SB is congruent to SR. We also have that this angle DSB is congruent to angle TSB because they are vertical angles and vertical angles are congruent. So for side angle side, we have one side, we have the included angle, so now we just need the other side. So since this is the included angle, the sides that need to be congruent are going to be ST and SD. So ST is congruent to SD. So you can see, indeed, we have side, included angle, side, and then side, included angle, side. And with that final answer, we wrap up this worksheet. As always, remember to click that subscribe button and give me a thumbs up on this video. Also, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.